Hey guys, you broke your prayers and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool promo where last week left off, I think, up two more wins in the Premier League, and it's getting silly at this point, because I had to ask in the last episode, is there still a title race? You'll see the league title, the league table here in a minute. I want you to remember something. I'm undefeated. The league. And the second place has changed. I'd say more than 15 times already. It seems to change almost every week.
It's raining. Is that going to help the attack?
Because the teams are screwing up. And by the teams, I mean the teams under me. Look at that. After say games, Chelsea could be in second. And I wouldn't bet past it.
Great to watch this Liverpool team.
Look at the way this season has been going. That could be. That is a very real possibility.
All areas of the pitch too. This is the Leicester City lineup. Probably one of the two front men will slip behind the other and augment the midfield when required.
I think so. If they start getting overloaded in the middle of the park, that's always an option for this manager who does like to fill his midfield.
This is the Liverpool side. Lloris can put them in front. Well, he's had a go.
Well, if you don't buy a ticket, as they say. And
I don't feel any pressure. Normally, I'm like, oh, if I win this game, I can take. I might be able to take extend my lead or make some. Gap. Or make a sizable stride towards winning the league title eventually in the season. But this season, and it was the same in the second season last FIFA. They seemed to stroll to the title and it. Anyone else just seemed to let it happen.
He didn't need any power, really, just enough to roll it past the goalkeeper because the placement was so good.
I think you've got to be playing with an awful lot of confidence to try that, and he is.
And I mean, if it happens again, I gotta ask, is there like some sort of second season bug or something? I mean,
could be dangerous. Sturridge, that's a spectacular.
I'm not doing anything different. I'm still winning my games as normal. Hold on. It's not like I didn't even change the team that much. I mean, one alteration. But anything I do doesn't really affect how the other teams perform. The only way I can influence how a result for another team is when I'm playing them, like Leicester here. Leicester are the only team I can influence this around the fixtures. Anyone else who drops points has nothing to do with me. But if they are their quote-unquote title right, those are might be challenging when the title comes. Might want to be considered title rivals, then any time they drop points, it's beneficial to me. And they seem to be dropping points left, right, and center.
Well, it was woeful.
Well, that looked promising, but he's been stopped. Money. He's coming.
I don't know, maybe I'm looking too much into it, but it just seems like for some reason, it almost seems like the other teams are more focused on screwing each other over than focusing on if anyone wants to build a title challenge. Because, like I said, the second place has changed so many times.
Visibility of the proceedings out there on the pitch.
Yeah. Which is like the only difference between the second season of this FIFA and the second season of FIFA 16. Because in FIFA 16, while Chelsea were dropping points, they were the team in second in the table. But even when they dropped points, they were in a position where maybe they dropped out a second once, but they're almost immediately back in the following week. So when they did drop points, once, maybe twice cost them second place. But like I said, it's changed them so much. Crystal Palace have been there, Manchester United, Chelsea, the Everton, and Arsenal, Manchester United. I mean, if it were possible to get every single team into second place before the end of the season, I'm sure the game would go for it. And the chance to make it 2-0 pulled just before the break. Eight Neto with the foul on the hood.
He saw the ball and he thought he could win it, but just a fraction off.
Alaba scores once again from the penalty spot. He is still perfect from the spot.
Good confidence, great connection.
Well, he enjoys the responsibility and he took that coolly.
Beautiful finish as well. Well, that is a top quality pen from the left back. Top quality.
At
2-0. I think that's like his 8th goal of the season as well. He's making a serious grind in the top goal scorer award. We just have to keep getting penalties if he's not going to miss any of them. I mean, eventually he's going to miss. Well, I guess it'll depend on whether the team
really strong tackle and the ball's gone out for a throw.
It's up to the game really, even whether he eventually misses. Because all I have to do is just make sure I keep picking the right direction.
The shot's on. That's great hands from the goalkeeper to make that kind of stuff.
And I don't have a certain side that I go to. Ooh, in fact, I almost always change it. I try to have a variety, so.
David Alaba.
And when he plays, whenever he gets a penalty, he goes the same side. He always goes to the right hand side of the goalkeeper. And I mean, and he says he scores 50% of his penalties. He's on average. And I'm like, well, I guess that's better than most. He says sometimes the keeper will go the right way, and sometimes the keeper won't. And he was convinced that the game, stored it in like a memory storage that where you went, and the next time the keeper could go at what? And he said it seems that way, because if he went right, like I said, he always seems to go, he always goes right, like he'll never go any other direction. So if you ever come up against someone online, because he plays online for champions. So if you ever come up against someone and you go to penalties with him and he's always going to the right hand side, that might be my dude.
You see this more and more.
If after two penalties they both or to the right hand side. Just see if they'll go to the right hand side the third time. Because if you can spot a pattern in how someone takes a penalty, in like a penalty shootout, then it could be easier to save the penalty and give yourself a better chance of beating that person. Now, there's no guarantee, that you're always going to come. Because almost everyone knows that you have to have a variety. And that's why I always try to mix it up.
That's great for.
I always either go to the left or go to the right. It depends on how I feel during that match. Like sometimes I'll go to the right, sometimes I'll go to the left. It'll depend. And where the game keeps a record of where you go for your penalties or not. I don't know if it does that. That would be a very unusual thing for EA to have included and not told us about. I mean, would you play past them? I mean, cheeky fuckers would try anything, but
looking for more.
At the end of the day, I don't think the game keeps a record. I think it's random where the keeper dives, and if you guess right, then you're golden, and if you guess wrong, then you're going to have to hope you have some luck on your side. And maybe the keeper won't dive in time, maybe the shot, maybe the pen will be too powerful for him, or maybe you put the hip on and it went over him. And there's so many variables when it comes to penalties.
The turn in terms of his form out here. Moving forward with some danger to the opposition now they're here.
He's got his shot off now. And the goalkeeper plunged to make the save. Getting set.
Nah. A good performance from the team. And another victory is inbound because I'm 4-0 up. But maybe 5 Sadio Mane is offside. Of course I'm offside.
Emre Can.
Oh boy. Oh, Sturgeon for Mino. I might have to get those two into the training session to work on their stamina. They seem to lose it faster than everybody else. I mean, they're not doing any more running than, say, like a Mane.
Well, this is how this team can play sustained attacking football, but when they lose it, as they've done now, it's just a risk.
But I don't know why they're so tired. Good challenge, Joel.
Comes out with a punch to clear the danger.
Lopez easily deals with the clearance, and Moya is clean through now. Hendy is trying to make up the room. Oh, I went too far with it. That should have been 5-0. In the end, it's not gonna matter, but still would have been nice to get the goal. Well, just to add to the goal scoring. In the end, like I said, that her 4-0 was a solid victory. Matt, Sturridge, Alaba, and Coutinho. You know, no, we don't need to see the penalty again. So yeah, solid victory.
Leicester City 0, Liverpool 4, West Bromwich Albion 0, Everton 0. So what do those results mean to the league table?
Look, Crystal Palace lost, which means if Chelsea win their match, they'll go into second place again. It's madness, I tell you.
In fourth, Manchester United.
Second place is may change again.
In sixth, Leicester City with 23 points. In seventh, Hull City with 23 points. In eighth, Arsenal with 21 points. Bottom of the table, Brighton and Hove.
It almost wouldn't be a second. There. He sees that without one. Hey! Chelsea didn't pass Palace, they lost as well. So, Chelsea and Palace both dropped points though. They both lost. Now Manchester United have made serious ground in the race for second place because the title race doesn't exist. I mean, look at that. I'm 14 points ahead of Crystal Palace, or in second, by 2 points. There's no title race. It doesn't exist. I may as well not have any matches against my rivals because they seem to be beating each other for me. Which is lovely, but as much as I'd love to just stroll and have a nice easy season where I just stroll to the title, well, easy as you like, I'd like some bit of challenge. Look at that, Chelsea and Palace both win, but when he beat West Brom, it's back to 14 points again. The gap is going to be 14 points, unless West Brom can stop me from winning. Which, I'm going to go with, no, that's not going to happen. No offense to West Brom fans, but my record speaks for itself.
Manchester City discuss. It's not been.
Here you can see West Brom's mid table. Smack dab at mid table in 10th.
Worried about what's going on so far this season.
Well, there's a top 10. Why it was highlighting Manchester City, I don't know, because that's not who I'm playing.
This is the Liverpool side. Lloris Karius is the goalkeeper today. David Alaba starts with Nathaniel Clyne as the wide defenders. Emre Can plays with Mahmoud Dahoud in the middle. In attack, Daniel Sturridge starts.
Firmino.
Tremendous ball recently. West Brom have one change.
Have another go at it, Roberto.
Gareth McCauley, who's suspended.
Sturridge! Nicely done. Thank you very much. Inside 6 minutes. In fact, pretty much on the dot 6 minutes. It is 1-0. I don't know, will that go down to 7-0? I mean, technically, it's still inside 6 minutes. Yes, it's 7-0. There you go. Not sure why that matters.
1-0 here.
2 goals in both. Now, in both matches for us. Now, Sturridge, he's back within 2 of Sadio Mane, who was on 23 after his last goal.
Just need to keep it going.
Where's 22 he's on? It's 22, he's only 1 by. 0. Now Daniel Sturridge is on 22, that is for sure. Or he is on fire! And West Brom are with the any sort of water or fire extinguisher for the speak of.
Efficiency in front of goal is phenomenal.
I mean, Ben Foster looks just stupid there.
Jonas Olsen.
Professional goalkeeper and he's makes it look absolute retarded. That's a good way to ensure your credibility. Make an absolute colossal fuck up. An important moment in the game.
Oh, he's true.
And it's a pitches coming at the goal again, and oh, the defender had to get there. It's the pitch already at 100% accuracy.
Anticipation.
Two goals from two shots.
Well,
foul there by Rondo. Yep. I knew he fouled so. Well, that's why I stopped. Sadio Mane. Hey. Okay. Oh, Evans. Had to stick it. Oh, like, you could easily continue the corner, but he got it away for the throw instead. In which, I guess, is better? Never mind. Instead of... what's his name? Left back guy who scored against Manchester United in that one game. He fucking acrobatically said, you know what? Fucking, they should have had a corner anyway. He fucking, giant Evans in the fucking dick. And fuck him. Pretty much. I'm adding a little bit more into it than there was, to be honest.
This particular manager and the
senior
international job, but we understand that he's turned that
Firmino.
He's got it.
Slay home. Oh. Now, I think that was Evans as well.
Nathaniel Clyne.
He'll come back in from Alaba. Sturridge! Good save from Foster. He wasn't going to be made to look foolish again by Daniel Sturridge. I think that was going over anyway. The goalkeepers are... I think goalkeepers are told not to take any chances. At least they should be anyway.
This home team have been unconquerable, home or away. A massive run that they're on, and just want to keep it going today.
Well, you look throughout the side and it's full of top class performers and all the players.
That's going to go out for the goal kick. I'm not going to attempt to prevent it when I can easily take the goal kick.
Nathaniel Clyne.
Firmino.
The break is definitely...
oh, another great pass today. Foster. Edge. Oh, he doesn't get the hat trick on this occasion. Firmino.
Opportunity here.
Merchant. Foster saves it. I'm not sure what Foster is doing. I mean, if that was an attempt to block the ball, it was a really, really bad attempt.
He's hung on to the ball.
There's a half-time whistle for a nice 2-0 lead going into the half. See the other games start happening at the moment. Of course, all my rivals, and again, I'm doing air quotes because I say rivals, they are not proving to rival me at all.
Really strong tackle, and the ball's gone out for a throw. Intercepted well.
I've already picked up the points.
Straightforward piece of work for the goalkeeper.
Yeah. Some damage has already been done in this episode. The fact that they've already lost their first game. opens the episode, it says that I will go into next episode 14 points ahead, because I'm two, nothing up here on West Brom. I mean, they've not looked like, in any way you look like they're gonna make a dent in that lead.
Comes in strongly. And that's gonna be a free kick.
Dude.
And it'll go into the middle now.
Good cross in, Firmino, in off the post. 3-0. Well, if the game wasn't already, it is now. 100%. Uber. Great connection there between the two Brazilian brothers from different mothers. Is the butt. Beats Firmino and Coutinho. Oh, connect. Seriously, who can connect almost telepathically? It's scary.
Game gets underway. Want to just freshen things up a bit here, West Brom, I think, with a substitution. He's coming forward with some danger. Out wide, they were in a good position until that defender.
Firmino. Sturridge.
Well, a real treat in store for you. Coverage on
Sunderland on the next game.
Liverpool, they'll be facing Sunderland away from
home. I don't know if that's... Actually, no, wait, that is in the Premier League because they've already played the quarter final of the League Cup there. Previous episode, and I got through that.
And the referee, Liverpool penalised.
Oh, hey, they forced the save out, Karius. At least they can say that from London. On our corner. Yes, it is. I wasn't too sure who would put it up, so thank you for clarifying that, Kate.
Chan.
And I will clarify that I have got it out of the fence. And now it's just being pulled back. Ah! I mean, that could be looked at as a foul, ref. Hello? No? Really? For you too, I guess.
I think they'll find it pretty easy in this one. Ledger. Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch. Good play.
Coutinho.
The opposition could get at them.
Dahoud.
3-0 now, almost over. And this should have a good...
Nathaniel Klein.
Well, Liverpool go up against Sunderland after this.
Mane 4-0. Oh, of course, Sadio Mane had to get his name on the score sheet. And hang on, this is the perfect time actually to. I'm not going to sub Daniel Sturridge off this occasion because he's on a hat trick. I'll sub off Sadio. Sorry, Sadio, but you're not on a hat trick. Daniel Sturridge is. Again, him and Firmino are really, really tired.
No slacking in these late minutes here. And a chance to extend their lead, and they have voraciously gobbled up the two.
Good finish. Really good football there today. Pretty easy finish, to be honest. Oh, so that was Sadio Mane's 23rd goal of the season. So, well, Sturridge was level, but now Mane is back in front. I mean, they're having a hell of a competition between them. At least there's something in kind of competition going involving Liverpool in some way or fashion. I love how it's going to be here. It's going to be more of a race for top goal scorer. or weren't than there will be for the Premier League title pool itself. And the top goals forward race is between two Liverpool players. Which just emphasizes it, doesn't it?
Here's a chance to attack.
45 goals that makes between the two of them. And that's just my strikers.
Now the shot! Well, the hands that didn't look so secure look a bit safer now.
Yeah, that'll make him feel a little bit better about himself.
Well, we're down to the last minute here. And that's a win confirmed for Liverpool.
It says a lot. It says a lot. And what also says a lot is that I picked up two more wins and I'm now 14 points clear of Crystal Palace, etc., etc.
So what do those results mean to the league table? At the top of the table remain Liverpool with 48 points. In second, Crystal Palace with 34 points. In third, Chelsea with 32 points. In fourth, Arsenal with 27 points. In fifth, Manchester United with 27 points. In sixth...
I love how the game is saying I'm basking in winning form. As goals, also keeping up.
In eighth, and falling are Leicester City with 23 points. Of the table, Brighton and Hove Albion.
Oh, my form. Just say I keep my form. I'm trying to roll on. Because that's the best way to describe it.
Swansea City with 15 points.
I mean, Sturridge's stamina is mad, but Firmino's isn't that bad. 79? I mean, that's only 20 less than the max. How is he always getting so tired then? I don't know. Oh. Anywho, well, what I do know is that this is the end of the episode. Thanks for watching. I'm enjoying it. Smash the like button if you subscribe. And until next time, I hope you all have a very nice day.